Today we are going to discuss further about the GAAP and the IC and the ASC and the IFRS systems. As we have touched these things in the previous lecture, now we will take up these things in detail. So moving further with the same topic, that is GAAP. In the previous lectures also we have discussed what is GAAP. It is simply collection of all the principles or the guidelines or the rules, the conventions and the concepts for companies which serves as a guideline for the companies who are required to prepare their books of accounts. So GAAP is basically, you can say, the set of rules which are required, or you can say it can be implemented in order to prepare the books of accounts. Now, going further with the details of GAAP, as we know that GAAP is the basic rules. This is a fact for GAAP that each and every country has its own structure of GAAP. It has own set of rules under GAAP, because each and every country has its own local accounting practices, you can say, own customs, own business environment. Each and every country has its own different features for running the business. Their requirements are different. Their working culture are different. Their usage of accounting information might be different. So keeping all these things in view, we can say that the GAAP for every country is different depending upon the requirements that the country needs to fulfill as per the accounting information they need to disclose or they need to use. So if we talk about India, we can say very well that the accounting standard board set up by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India on 22nd April 1977, and this is the body which is responsible for issuing the accounting standards which is to be used by the Indian companies. So this Indian you can say setup is like this, that accounting standard board is there, which is being set up by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and this is the body who is responsible for issuing GAAP in India, which is to be further used by the Indian companies in order to disclose their accounting information, in order to frame up their accounting information, or you can say this is the set of rules given by ASB, which is to be used by the Indian companies while preparing their books of accounts. Moving further with ASB, you know very well that ASB is the main body who makes up the rules, who decide on the rules, who go through with the whole process of designing and formulating the rules, regulations, policies, or in short, we can say the GAAP. So while formulating the GAAP, there is one thing which ASB needs to focus here, is that the GAAP should be formed by considering, or you can say after considering, the International Financial Reporting Standards, which is given by the international body. So while the ASB is framing the rules and regulations for the Indian perspective, they need to very well understand that what are the international accounting standards, and to the maximum extent possible, they need to incorporate the international standards into the GAAP prepared for the specifically for the Indian companies. So when the international standards are there, the role of ASB is this, that they should focus on the international standards, and to the maximum extent what we can converge from the international standard, it should be there. It should be the part of the GAAP in Indian perspective. So this is the major role of accounting standards board. Though we have studied in the previous slide also that each and every country has its own GAAP, because their own requirements are there, their own different culture is there, their own different usage of information is there. But the bottom line is this, to give a uniformity at the international level also. See, we were talking about the rules and regulations for the country level, that in order to give a uniformity all over the country, the rules and regulations should be framed out so that the accounting information given by all the countries should be comparable with each other. That is why some common gaps has been framed up, which should be used by the Indian companies to frame out their like accounting information. But if we were talking about the country level only, but think about the same thing at the international level. At the international level also, it is required that the country should have certain level of uniformity while preparing their books of accounts. So for that perspective, the international body has issued IFRS, that is the International Financial Reporting Standard. So it becomes the responsibility of each and every country to incorporate these international standards to the maximum extent possible, keeping their indigenous customs, usages, business environments in mind, that how much they can incorporate those international standards into their own GAAP while framing out their indigenous policies or the guidelines or the rules and regulations. So this is the basic function, you can say, of ASB in India or in any of the countries, the bodies who are responsible for framing out the policies or the guidelines or the rules and regulations for preparing the accounting information. So moving further with this, as we have understood that ASB is the accounting standard board which is responsible for preparing the GAAP, and it is, you can say, it is formed by Indian Chartered Accountant Institute. Now, coming to IFRS, as we have used these terms in the previous lectures also, in the previous slides here also, IFRS are the accounting standards that are issued by the International Accounting Standards Board with the objective of providing a common accounting language to increase the transparency in the presentation of financial information. This is what we were discussing about in the previous slide also, that IFRS is being introduced in order to maintain a uniformity at the international level also, so that there should be, at the international level, there should be some rules and regulations that will be guiding the countries all over the world, that to what extent or with what intention or with what dimension they have to think about while preparing their own rules and regulations for documenting the accounting information. Now coming to the IASB, International Accounting Standard Board is an independent body formed in 2001 with the sole responsibility of establishing the International Financial Reporting Standards, that is IFRS. It succeeded the International Accounting Standards Committee, which was earlier given the responsibility of establishing the International Accounting Standards. IASB is based in London. Now, coming to the next slide, it will make you more clear what we were talking about See, IS is the term which we used previously for the International Accounting Standards. International Accounting Standards Committee is being framed in 1973, who is responsible for issuing the International Accounting Standards, that is IAS. Now, IAS is being issued from IS-1 to IS-40 by IAST from year 1973 to 2001. But in 2001, this IASC has been converted into International Accounting Standards Board, and the nomenclature of IAS has been changed from IAS to IFRS. There is nothing different in it. The rules have been changed. Only certain rephrasing, reformulations have been done in IAS and given a new nomenclature, that is IFRS, International Financial Reporting Standards. So since 2001, this IFRS is in existence, and IASB is the responsible body for issuing these IFRS. And IFRS 1 from IFRS 17 is being issued up to now for the purpose of further considering it for the countries for preparing their own GAAP. This is the difference between IAS. IAS is the older term that we use for International Accounting Standards, and which has been now called as the IFRS. Coming to Indian Accounting Standards, Indian Accounting Standards is the part of GAAP only, and it gives you the basic rules, the guidelines or certain specific rules and regulations that you need to follow while preparing your accounting information. So if we talk about Indian accounting standard, it specifically talks about the Indian rules and regulations given by ASB to the different companies working in India, that how they need to prepare their accounting information. And while developing the Indian accounting standards by the ASB, as we have discussed in the previous lectures also, that IFRS should be kept in mind, that what IFRS says about the particular information, about the particular perspective or about the particular dimension, and keeping that in mind only, we have to converge that IFRS into our Indian accounting standards. So Indian accounting standards are nothing else but the converged form of IFRS, that we have converged what IFRS is saying into our Indian accounting standards. As per our own culture, as per our own traditions, as per our own requirements and the business environment in which the business are being running in this country. So now I guess you people are clear with what is IFRS, what is ISB, what is ISB. Now moving on to the accounting standards. These are the different accounting standards. As in India, we have accounting standards from 1 to accounting standard 29. And you can see here that accounting standard 6 and accounting standard 8 is missing here, which has been which was earlier in existence, but now it has been withdrawn by ASB. So up till now, we have accounting standard 1, accounting standard 2, continuing till accounting standard 29, and there is two standards which has been withdrawn, accounting standard 6 and 8, which is being withdrawn from the current structure. So for the further reference, I have mentioned you all these accounting standards here. If you want, you can go in detail also about it, but up till your level, it is not required to go much deeper into the accounting standards. And more of, we will be discussing these things in detail when we will be coming up with the future lectures, where we will be preparing the accounting information in different accounting formats, like journal ledger, trial balance, or how to treat the depreciation, fixed assets. So these all things we will be touching up in the future lectures. So if still you want to go into detail, I have given these accounting standards for your reference. You can work on it on your own and go out for the further details in it. Thank you for this. We'll meet again in the next lecture.